Senator Dianne Feinstein gets into a heated discussion with a group of kids representing the Sunrise Movement Friday. A group of middle and high school aged children met with the senator Friday to request that she back the Green New Deal. Now, a video posted by the Sunrise Movement shows the senator and the children debating that deal.
The senator argues that the policy will not pass the Senate. She says she doesn't agree with it. Listen to this exchange for yourself here.
We are trying to ask you to vote yes on the Green New Deal.
Please.
Okay, I'll tell you what. We have our own Green New Deal piece of legislation. There are reasons why I can't, because there's no way to pay for it.
Yes, there is.
Well,
that's
we have tons of money.
Government is supposed to be for the people and by the people and all for the people.
You know what's interesting about this group is I've been doing this for 30 years. I know what I'm doing. You come in here and you say it has to be my way or the highway. I don't respond to that.
We're the people who voted you. You're supposed to listen to us. That's your
job. How old are you?
I'm 16. I can't vote.
You didn't vote for me.
Well, she voted.
It doesn't matter. We're the ones who's going to be impacted.
Well, you know better than I do. So I think one day you should run for the Senate.
Great. I
so Senator Feinstein, she did provide the group with an alternative climate resolution proposal, saying she believes it has a better chance of passing. In a statement last night, though, this is what she said in part. She said, unfortunately, it was a brief meeting, but I want the children to know they were heard loud and clear. I've been and remain committed to doing everything I can to enact real, meaningful climate change legislation. I always welcome the opportunity to hear from Californians who feel passionately about the issue, and it remains a top priority of mine.
All right, joining me now, CNN political commentator and political anchor for Spectrum News, Errol Lewis. Errol, good morning to you.
Good morning.
So what do you think, a misstep by Senator Feinstein, or if you send children into a senator's office demanding something, sometimes they're going to get a no?
Well, that's right. Look, in the short term, yes. If there's a playbook on how to be a politician, it probably would need to include don't argue with children in front of the cameras. So to that extent, it looks a little bit bad for Senator Feinstein, but there's an underlying political point that I don't think she made very well, but it's a real one, which is that this resolution, it's sort of a sense of the House. It's not something that is intended to truly implement most of the ideas that are laid out in the Green New Deal. And you actually hear some of the organizers acknowledging that towards the end, sort of saying, look, we just want to make a symbolic statement about where the United States needs to go. The bill is, in fact, going to come up next week. It is probably not going to pass. Senator Feinstein could have played along with them, but she chose to try and engage them, and I would actually give her credit for that.
So is this effective? I mean, let's put the video back up. I mean, these are our young children going into the senator kind of saying, you have to listen to us. It is our future, and we want you to do this. We voted for you, but then she said she was 16. Is this they've gone into other representatives and senators' offices. Does it work?
I'm not so sure about the targets. I understand kind of where they're coming from. I've been known to do a little protesting myself way back when I was a young man. And you do want to sort of pin people in a corner morally. That's the whole point of the exercise. And so they're doing what they're supposed to be doing. What has mystified me about the Sunrise Movement really from the beginning is that one of their first targets was, you know, Nancy Pelosi. Now one of their targets is Dianne Feinstein. These are some of the most liberal members of Congress. They come from a state, California, that's actually led the way in renewables and in emission standards and all kinds of important elements of the environmental movement. And so I wonder why they don't take this to some of the oil and gas industry funded senators from some of the other states, the people who are standing in the way of them and their goal. But other than that, no, I think this is exactly what young people are supposed to do, to sort of put a stake in the ground, to call for exactly what it is they want, and to always answer why not when the establishment says it's not practical, we can't do it just yet.